Request Animation Frame should be your go-to tool for creating animations. Nobody likes to be interrupted in the middle of a task, and the browser is no different. Remember how little time the browser has to render the frame at 60 frames a second. If 1 second is 1,000 milliseconds, and we have to fit 60 frames in, well, we have 16 milliseconds. Realistically, though, there's some overhead to running a frame, and the browser has housekeeping to do, so we should aim for about 10 milliseconds instead. The JavaScript part of your frame should typically be kept around 3 to 4 milliseconds at most, because there's going to be other work like style calculations, layer management, and compositing that will come afterwards. I want you to imagine that the browser is in the middle of doing some style work. And then in comes some JavaScript that needs attention. The browser now has to deal with the JavaScript that just came in before it can move on to other tasks. That new JavaScript may cause the work for the frame to be redone, and that could well mean missing the frame. Request Animation Frame schedules your JavaScript to run at the earliest possible moment in each frame. That gives the browser as much time as possible to run your code, then style, then the layout, painting, and compositing. A lot of older code around the web that is used for animation uses set timeout or set interval, because back in the day, that's all there was. In fact, jQuery still uses set timeout for its animation today. The problem with both of these functions is that the JavaScript engine pays no attention to the rendering pipeline when scheduling these. They're good functions to use when you want to wait some time to elapse or do some repeated task every so often, but they're not a good fit for animations. This is how you use Request Animation Frame. You make a call to it and tell it which function you want it to call. That gets called where you do your animation, and at the end of it, you schedule the next one. The browser takes care of when it should run and how. Of the many browsers available to users today, the only one that doesn't support Request Animation Frame is Internet Explorer 9. So for that, you need to use a polyfill, which would use set timeout. It's not ideal as a fallback, but it will allow you at least to use Request Animation Frame in your code and not worry about compatibility. Check out the instructor notes for more information.